Stopping Nosebleeds by Cautery by Dr. Christopher Chang. Produced by Faulkner ENT Consultants of Warrenton, Virginia. Here we have a patient who has been having persistent nosebleeds from the left side. The first step is to carefully examine the nose on both sides to find the source of the bleeding. The most common location for a nosebleed is from the anterior septum. The bleeding site is noted by the green arrow here. Once the bleeding site is found, a cotton ball soaked with 4% lidocaine is placed into the nose. Lidocaine will numb up the area so that there will be no pain with the cauterization. It is not unusual that the upper lip as well as the front teeth also becomes numb. While waiting for the numbing to take effect, a silver nitrate stick is obtained. When silver nitrate is applied to the bleeding site, cauterization will occur through a chemical reaction. The silver nitrate is at the tip of the stick. Once adequate anesthesia is obtained, the cotton ball soaked with lidocaine is removed. The silver nitrate is now applied directly on the area where the nosebleed is coming from. Typically, the bleeding sites are areas where the blood vessel is found close to the surface. As cauterization occurs, you'll notice that the mucosa starts to turn white. The scar tissue that develops as the area heals after cauterization is what stops the bleeding. Once adequate cauterization has been performed, the silver nitrate stick is removed. If the bleeding site is more significant, electrocauterization may need to be performed. If the nosebleed is severe enough, the nose may need to be packed with a tampon-like device. After cauterization, patients are instructed to use Pinars to allow the area to heal properly.